Fellas, it's Rambo, and I'm here with another Dead Ops Arcade 3 video, where I'll be going over the changes made to the game throughout the month of August. Before we start the video, it is worth mentioning that in the description below will be a link to a Google Doc, which lists all the changes made to the DOA series, so you could check that out if you wanted to. Speaking of the description, timestamps for this video will be there as well, so let's get right into it. Address an issue introduced in the July 20th update, where players would die in just one hit to both traps and certain enemy attacks, while in first-person perspective, in buggy cars, or with a Divine Shield potion equipped. The Season 5 update on August 12th added Akari Exit as a bonus area which is accessible in the wild, near a newly added location by the beginning of the volcano. This bonus area has a timer of 10 minutes, and has an abundance of loot and enemies. It is worth noting that deaths in this bonus area will deduct lives from your HUD. A lot of the changes made with the Season 5 update were not listed on the official patch notes. Those additional changes are as follows. Address the bug where DOA 3 was not playable in local mode for consoles. When driving a buggy car near the lift by the Kaboom Room, the buggy car will self-destruct to prevent exploits in that area. Added collision to certain areas on various arenas to limit the likelihood of eggs bouncing outside the boundaries of the map. Addressed an issue where meatballs could roll outside the map on Wave 2 of the Room of Judgment. Partial leaderboard reset was performed for all categories except for Career. However, unlike previous leaderboard resets on this game, only entries with rounds higher than 80 were reset this time around. Introduced a bug where collision in certain doorways can prevent players from exiting the map at the end of certain rounds, such as players being unable to exit the top door on rounds 21 and 23. Introduced a bug where players can be stuck inside of a doorway when transitioning to a new round, such as when exiting the top right door on rounds 25 and 27. Introduced a bug where gladiators can get stuck inside doorways on Wave 3 of the Room of Judgment. Introduced a bug in the Graveyard Arena, where only one of the doorways would have active zombie spawners. Introduced new invisible barriers near one of the doorways on the Graveyard Arena. Introduced a bug where some of the fireballs on both the Throne Room and Island Arenas would get stuck inside of their cannons, thus not landing properly onto the map. Altered the appearance of the lobby creation menu for private matches, where they now more so resemble that of public matches. Addressed an exploit on the Bloodpool Arena near the Waterfall Bushes. As a result, there is now less mobility in that area. And finally, addressed various other exploits, such as one on the Barrels Arena. The August 13th update made a couple of quick temporary fixes, addressed an issue introduced in the previous update, where zombies now typically spawn out of more than just one doorway on the Graveyard Arena. Addressed a bug introduced in the previous update, where the player is no longer provided exit arrows to specific doorways where they would previously get stuck inside of on the Shadow Boogie and Afterlife Arenas. And finally, addressed various exploits where zombies would not target the player. Only one update on August 17th, addressed an issue introduced in the August 12th update, where gladiators would get stuck inside of doorways during Wave 3 of the Room of Judgment. Now, several gladiators will spawn in the middle of the map every 20 seconds. Made some balance adjustments to the Akari exit bonus area, where it is no longer in the recurring rotation after round 140. In the Akari exit bonus area, the player is no longer able to trigger the pressure plate near the Margua just by jumping on the above key chest. Address an issue introduced in the August 13th update, where zombies would not spawn in for a few seconds at a time, specifically during the Shadow Boogie Arena. And finally, lava in the wild now deals much more damage than previously. And finally, only one update on August 26th, as the player is now awarded 1000 XP when taking the final exit in the Akari exit bonus area. Anyways, that about wraps up the video. If you found the video to be helpful, don't forget to drop a like. Thanks for watching.